and sweet and gay, from down the bank would come Mother's placating voice. I'm coming! Yoo-hoo! Just mislaid my gloves. Wait a second! I'm coming, my dears! Puffing and smiling, hat crooked, scarf dangling, clutching her baskets and bags, she'd come hobbling at last through the stinging nettles and climb, hiccuping, into her seat. Our mother was a buffoon, extravagant and romantic, and was never wholly taken seriously. Yet within her she nourished a delicacy of taste, a sensibility, a brightness of spirit, which though continuously bludgeoned by the cruelties of her luck, remained uncrushed and unembittered to the end. Wherever she got it from, God knows, or how she managed to preserve it. But she loved this world and saw it with fresh hopes that never clouded. She was an artist, a light giver, and an original. And she never for a moment knew it. With her love of finery, her unmade beds, her litters of unfinished scrapbooks, her taboos, superstitions, and prudishness, her remarkable dignity, her pity for the persecuted, her awe of the gentry, and her detailed knowledge of the family trees or even royal houses of Europe, she was a disorganised mass of unreconciled denials. A servant girl, born to silk. Yet in spite of all this, she fed our oafish wits with steady, imperceptible shocks of beauty. Though she tortured our patience and exhausted our nerves, she was all the time building up around us by the unconscious revelations of her loves, an interpretation of man and the natural world so unpretentious and easy that we'd never recognised it then, yet so true that we never forgot it. Nothing now that I ever see that has the edge of gold around it, the change of a season, a jewelled bird in a bush, the eyes of orchids, water in the evening, a thistle, a picture, a poem, but my pleasure pays some brief duty to her. She tried me at times to the top of my bent, but I absorbed from birth, as now I know, the whole earth through her jaunty spirit.
Mm.